Shadow Work Part 2. Secrets, Karma, and Contracts. A lot of times we don't do the shadow work because we don't know that we need to. We don't even often understand that there's pain there, or we've been told not to focus on it, that healing in that particular area doesn't necessarily need to be done, or that it's normal. When things get normalized, we will often carry the pain and never do the work because it's socially acceptable. You can't get to true shadow work while being indoctrinated into an often mentally ill, Christian, male-dominated, patriarchal, colonized, for-profit medical system society like we live in. So let's not forget that so many of the burdens that we carry and the trauma that we have been normalized through the indoctrination of that system. Doctors and therapists aren't going to help you to confront a lot of the issues associated with the patriarchy or colonization, because that would cost them in the system. They are able to benefit from keeping the system this way. So unless you have some really out of the box thinkers helping you, doctors and therapists, you're pretty much trapped, and they aren't going to rebel against the system, bite the hand that feeds them. So we all need to be on our own journey of exploration. The biggest secret and where the most karma is hiding right there in the patriarchal system, the colonization and the damage that it has done. So as individuals, look deep at how you've been programmed and see if you have shadow work that needs to be done in those areas, especially with generational trauma that needs to occur. And it's going to be complicated finding people who will help you with that. Don't ever forget that your ancestors are working with you all the time, that spirit, your guides are always there, that the universe is supporting you in going high and getting out of a low system. Sometimes it's best to just tune everything else out and tune in this way.
Everybody is experiencing this Saturn Uranus square, and Saturn is the planet of karma. Uranus is the planet of breaking free. It's pushing us to break it free. So that think out of the box, or, you know, don't follow those societal norms that are no longer serving us. Those are, that's what we are going through as a population. And then it also goes down into our individual lives. So these planets are like opposite, and they're coming together and they're saying, look, you have to break out. So, you know, the patriarchal system, you know, women coming into power, LGBTQ and Black Lives Matters and everything like coming up now, like that is really disturbing people because it disturbs what we've built. Karma is on, you know, a collective level and also an individual level. And you do have karma from this life as well as karma contracts from other lives. Everybody has a shadow side. And when we look at shadow work, but there are planetary triggers that will come up and kind of push this, you know? So last year as a collective, we had Pluto Saturn, right? So Pluto, death and rebirth, and Saturn, what we built. So we're still this is still happening. But on an individual level, when you were born, your planets are all in that contract. And somehow that has to be played out.
Pluto Saturn happened last year. Mm-hmm. And so that was the beginning of the purging.
And the pandemic of, like, and all
exposing of all of our dysfunction.
Showing us that we needed to rebuild. There was no choice. But you had the people, the Saturn people would hang on and say, no, it has to be this way, traditional. You know, Saturn's very tradition. And Uranus just wants brand new. And, you know, so it's the struggle against the two. Where are you trying to hang on? And where are you trying to break free? Like there's something going on in everybody's life where they're having that dynamic where they're being sort of pushed to make the change, because as humans, we never want to make the change. The last hit of this is December 24th. When Pluto comes and makes a transit to either an angle or a planet, it's going to put all your shadow up so that you can see it now. Like it brings it to the surface. This is like, you know, when you were having like the hardest time in your life, might have been a Pluto transit.
That is what I think a lot of people are experiencing when they talk about the dark night of the soul.
We will attract people in our lives during a Pluto transit that reflect to us our shadow. Temptation is huge with Pluto. There's so much temptation. When you resist temptation, that strengthens you.
It's so important in this particular situation, how dark it gets, that we understand that there is an end point. Even the Pluto transit will eventually come to an end. The sun comes out and things get easier and the healing process can really start to take place. It's so important we remember that we understand that as a truth.
And I think that's really where detachment comes in. It really is key to these Pluto transits because you will be all consumed. Yes. And you may fall really hard if you are not conscious. And maybe that has to happen. But, you know, if you're learning from it as you go, like you just have to know, I got to go through hell and then I come out. And I come out better for it. I do want to discuss like some ways to deal with it. Think about Pluto as like alchemy, you know, turning lead into gold. Shadow work, if you are brave enough to face it. And that's the thing, like Pluto's going to make you brave. You know, Saturn will make you brave.
The fittest are those that learn to use alchemy.
Mm-hmm.
Pay attention to what their ego is supposed to be teaching them. Understanding free will and going high versus low. That's who survives. That's who thrives. But if we really want to evolve into the future and eventually maybe reach a point where we don't have to recycle, reincarnate into this over and over and over again, we have to master this. It's like people want to say, well, I'm not a colonizer. Well, that's my ancestor's problem. Well, that was my great grandfather. Well, whatever. It's not our problem. We need to get on track today. It's still today. This is all the same day.
Yeah.
And we're still suffering the consequences of those horrific choices. That's how we heal, is by facing it once and for all. And you can see that split and that divide in the people right there.
We want to look at it as a lesson, and it might be a really horrible, awful lesson, but a lesson nonetheless that, you know, for some reason your soul had to go through.
A lot of talk right now too about, you know, screw forgiveness. We do need to understand that forgiveness, alchemy, using these opportunities of pain to do the shadow work and convert the negativity into positivity is our job. It should not be dismissed. And it doesn't have anything to do with the person who did you harm or the situation that occurred. It has to do with you taking your power back and saying, I'm not going to allow it to continuously hold me down.
There's going to be crisis in your life. You can't avoid it.
Right.
You just can't. And accepting what has happened is a really important thing, because if we don't have acceptance, we're fighting something that already happened.
You can't get there. You can't get to that heightened place. You can't really be woke until you're willing to do the shadow work.